This video is for Louis Rossman. If you're not familiar with Louis Rossman, he makes videos here on YouTube, and he advocates for right to repair, and he also takes up companies who are not treating their customers with respect. I think that's probably the best way to put it. At least that's how I look at it. I've watched several of his videos. Of all the videos I've seen of his, he makes really good sound on his videos. He is looking to upgrade his older Sennheiser G3 wireless microphone system, which he attaches to a Zoom F3. So he asked if I would check the noise performance of the new Sennheiser wireless microphone system. This is the EW-DP, and specifically, this is the plug-on transmitter called the SKP. Asked if I would check the self-noise performance of this, because you can record directly to this in 32-bit float. So we did exactly that. First, we measured self-noise of the SKP and the F3 by plugging in a dummy XLR connector with a 150-ohm resistor across pins 2 and 3. This simulates the load of a microphone, but without capturing the sound from the microphone. So this is kind of a clinical measurement of the microphone preamplifier's self-noise, the self-noise generated by the preamplifier itself in both the SKP and the F3. So we measured both of them. They came in, both of them, in fact, at minus 129 dB RMS max on those sample recordings. That's really good. So if you weren't clear on what that means, that's very low self-noise. But we also did a more practical sample recording where I recorded some dialogue, so this is more real world. I connected a Sennheiser MKH50 to both the SKP and a Zoom F3, and we boomed it about 18 inches out of the frame, 45 centimeters from me, recorded dialogue and a few seconds of silence, and then we brought that into post-production, normalized the entire thing to minus 26 LUFS mono, or which is the equivalent of minus 23 LUFS stereo. And then I measured that silent portion, and in both cases, for both the SKP and the Zoom F3, it came in at minus 60 dB RMS max. Also very good. So there's your answer, Louis. Then, as soon as I finished that part of the recording, I went to go message Louis, and he had already messaged me literally 15 minutes before and said he's going to stick with his old setup because he got his hands on an SKP and was not able to get it to record because, for whatever reason, the SD card or microSD card that he's using wasn't working with the SKP. So I can say that some recorders tend to be pretty sensitive. They work with some cards and not with others. I don't really know what that is, but what I have found, and most of the people I've talked to have run into that issue generally, not just with the SKP, but generally, is that typically they're using higher performance cards, newer cards, more expensive cards. And the weird thing is that audio recorders, a lot of times, tend to do better with less expensive cards. In this one, for example, I'm using a $15 SanDisk card. It's nothing special, and it's working just fine. So in any case, Louis, sorry that the SKP didn't work out for you, but continue making great sound.